After moving into the restaurant, the group of diners noticed the growing crowd outside and were informed by the wait staff that several Taylor security officers were sitting just a few booths away. Eager to catch a glimpse of the pop superstar, they decided to head upstairs, only to find the doors locked and guarded, leading to joyful laughter at their daring attempt. Although diners missed the chance to see the couple up close, this unique experience left them in awe. The patron summed up the evening by saying, "I wish I could have seen her, but it was wonderful." Couple Swift, Kelsey and their friends spent a night enjoying the most beautiful ocean views at Nobu Malibu, which is also said to be the most romantic getaway. Swift and Kelsey have been trying to spend as much time together as possible between the cruel summer, singer taking a break from his world tour, and the Kansas City Chiefs tight ends offseason from the NFL. The All Too Well hitmaker and the three-time Super Bowl champion first went public with their relationship in September 2023 and have been going strong ever since. It's so romantic, the moment Travis Kelce held his girlfriend Taylor Swift's hand and escorted her to the car, to leave the restaurant after dinner at Nobu Malibu. "Monday night we spotted the couple holding hands and leaving Nobu Malibu, after they rented out the restaurant for a private party with their friends," a witness told NatFL. "Travis bought the restaurant for his girlfriend and her group. Taylor arrived wearing a denim dress and was seen snacking, drinking some cocktails and dancing with Travis," one diner told NatFL. "So we went to Nobu Malibu for my friend's 22nd birthday. They informed us before we left that they were having a closing party. Tough time at 8 p.m. and of course, when we saw that Taylor and Travis arrived at the restaurant, we understood that they had rented out the whole restaurant to their group." As the clock neared 8 p.m., restaurant staff approached diners with takeout boxes, informing them that they had to leave the premises. To make up for the early closing, the staff graciously provided free drinks at the sister restaurant a few floors away. Restaurant patrons can't help but wonder if this unusual situation is for Taylor and Travis's benefit. When asked about the unexpected development, restaurant staff kept it a secret, smiled and replied that they cannot confirm or deny the reason for the sudden closure. However, as the conversation with the staff continued, it became clear that they were excited about the special guests attending and even promised to say hello to Taylor. "Travis Kelce, the happiest I've ever been, in blossoming Taylor Swift relationship and Super Bowl glory with the Chiefs. I'm oozing life right now, everything seems to be full throttle." The 34-year-old helped his Chiefs team to the third Super Bowl title of his career in February and their second in a row, meaning next season they will have a shot at an historic and unprecedented three-peat in the NFL, away from the field. He has been on vacation in the Caribbean with girlfriend Swift and recently announced the return of his Kelce Jam Music Festival in Kansas City. Furthermore, his New Heights podcast that he hosts with older brother Jason has just been nominated for a Webby. He is also planning to open a steakhouse in Kansas City with teammate Patrick Mahomes in early 2025. "I'm the happiest I've ever been. I'm a guy that some people say is glass half full, half empty, and my glass is all the way full. It's all the way full," Kelce told NatFL. "I'm oozing life right now. It's just so much fun getting into when you win the Super Bowl, all these doors open, and so I've just been going through all these open doors, experiencing life and just appreciating the people that have got me here and also staying high and meeting new faces. It doesn't feel like there's much chill in my life. Everything seems to be full throttle and just moving at the speed of light, and that's how I kind of like it." Kelce was pictured in Los Angeles with his brother Jason and has admitted that he is having conversations with figures in the entertainment industry about life after football. "I like it to be up pace. I like to have just exciting things going on," Kelce explained, "and sure enough, I'm out here in the entertainment world trying to dabble into that before I get back locked in on football and knowing that that's going to be my focus until I'm done playing. But to dabble around in the entertainment space is something that I'm really interested in." While the NFL season won't start until September, the Chiefs will start holding organized team activities from May as part of the build-up to the new campaign. There is also a mandatory minicamp from June 11th to 13th that Kelce will be expected to attend. The schedule for the new season, meanwhile, is expected to come out in May. Taylor Swift and Travis Kelce planning to attend Coachella together as they want to see her BFF Lana Del Rey perform. The songstress, 34, who is currently on a two-month break from her The Eras tour, will be renting a house in the area with the NFL star, 34, for one of the two festival weekends on April 12 to 14 and April 19 to 21, a source told NatFL. They added, they both want to see Lana Del Rey and Jack Antonoff's band, Bleachers. A second source claimed Kelce will stay with Swift until late April, with the hunk said to be shooting a commercial in Los Angeles the weekend of April 12. A third insider added, Taylor is very excited about the opportunities Travis is getting and fully supports him. But she wants him to be conscious of his schedule. The only issue is making sure they can see each other. They're having so much fun and enjoying things. The pair's relationship is said to be very serious and has them thinking of next steps, adding fuel to the fire, Kelce told People, I am a Coachella guy. I love going to Coachella. I love live music in general. So you might see me pop up over there at some point. I'm not sure if I'll go to a weekend, one or two, or if I even have time, knowing my schedule's filling up pretty quick before we get started back up for football here. This comes after the pair, who started dating in September, celebrated the break in Taylor's sold-out Eras tour by jetting off on a romantic getaway together. Photographers caught the pair packing on the PDA while enjoying the sunshine on the island vacation on Thursday. Dressed in a skimpy yellow bikini from the brand Montz, the singer showed off her stunning physique during the intimate beach day. Fans who have been tracking the pop star's private jet claimed that it flew from Los Angeles to North Eleuthera on March 10. One day later, popular Instagram account Dumois posted pictures of what appeared to be the couple hanging out on a dock in the Bahamas together. During the first few months of their romance, Taylor and Travis spent much of their time jetting off to see one another amid their busy schedules. But things have slowed down for them as of late. With her latest leg of the Cruel Summer Songstress Eras tour ending in early March and the athlete's football season coming to an end last month, after a wild 6 months filled with busy schedules, constant traveling, and cameras surrounding their every move, it was said that the pair were planning to play house inside her $25 million Beverly Hills mansion. They are enjoying movie nights in her home theater, catching up on films and shows they've missed, an insider told Us Weekly earlier this month. They can finally rest and intend on spending quality time together and with friends and family. This is the first time the two of them have had no commitments, and they are both really looking forward to being a normal couple and playing house. But it seems they took a break from nesting to enjoy a lavish vacation together in the Bahamas. Last week, the NatFL revealed the shocking amount of money that Travis had reportedly spent on wooing Taylor. The publication estimated that he spent a whopping $8 million on everything from private jet rides to lavish gifts. It claimed that Travis spent around $22,000 on Valentine's Day presents for the pop star alone. These are said to have included a slew of designer clothes and accessories, a $3,050 24-karat gold rose sculpture from the luxury furniture company Perigold, and two boxes of 250 roses, Eternity Roses, which are said to last up to a year and cost $2,199 each. And it didn't end there. It was also reported that he gifted her a $1,050 black lambskin Dior beret, a $1,100 Celine hat, a $5,100 Bottega Veneta purse, and a $1,300 Hermes Chavaux de Chains shawl. Last but not least, the athlete got himself and Taylor, whose net worth is estimated to be $1.1 billion. Custom matching bracelets with the letters TNT, standing for Taylor and Travis, written in diamond-encrusted gold beads. The outlet added that Travis has already forked over $1.2 million on private jet rides so that he could support his girlfriend at her shows. By far Travis' greatest expense, however, was the new home he felt the need to buy after he started dating the hitmaker. He bought a 17,000-square-foot mansion in the Kansas City suburb of Leawood for $6 million, after his $1 million house reportedly made him feel self-conscious. His new abode comes with 6 bedrooms, 6 bathrooms, a Beverly Hills-style pool, a garage with space for 6 cars, a tennis and pickleball court, a miniature golf course, a wine cellar, a 2-level cinema room, and a substantial garden to give him and Taylor extra privacy from fans and the media.